Sagittarius, hello there, my beautiful friends. We're going to do your general tarot reading for early August 2024. Thank you so much for joining me today. You know, I appreciate each and every single one of you. So let's get right down to business as always and start you off with an oracle card here, just so we could dip our toes in energy and see what's happening for the lovely Sagittarius collective. Hope you're all doing fabulous and fantastic, my friends. Let's get it going. Guides and spirit team, talk to me about the Saggies. What do we got in Leo season for the Sagittarius collective? What energies, messages, insights can we take a good look at? And yeah, we're just going to check out this first card real quick, and we'll get into the full reading itself. And at the very end, I'll pull you a bonus card from the Shadowland Tarot, just to see what might be in the shadows or what shadow work you can lean in on, which is always interesting. But let's get it going here. Let's rock and see what we got for Saggy in early August. Please and thank you. What's happening for my good friends? Quick, very first shuffle. Got a very similar thing for the Leo reading as well. And it's something that's been showing up within all the fire signs. So it does feel like a theme. We see this little individual. It looks like she's either doing yoga or taking a nap. Maybe a bit of both, right? But this is a nice etheric type of energy. And it also has spiritual undertones. And before we fully dive into that, if you're new here, I'll be speaking about the August subscriber surprise towards the end. So you might want to check that out. And also, if you could kindly illuminate that like button by tapping it right on its third eye, you know, I'd greatly appreciate it. But enough of the promo, into the reading. Let's talk more about this card. So yeah, the image to me, you see this lady, it's like she's bent. And I always say it's either some sort of meditation or yoga thing, but she's also covered with a blanket. Very etheric looking card. So this could represent sleep, rest, relaxation. Maybe some of you could be going on a vacation or you need one. I feel like that's something I saw for you like within the last week or two, that there was something here about needing to take a rest, and this card does represent it. For some of you, it might just be your dreams showing up here. You might be having interesting vivid dreams, or spirit could be trying to commune with you in that way. But to me, I also feel like this is an extremely imaginative card. It's a spiritual card. Now is a great time to get in touch with your own personal spirituality, whatever that might be. Okay, so whether it's like a strict religion, whether it's your own form or thing, spirit wants you to connect. That's what I'm picking up here with this card in a very big way. And when it comes to the self-expression, the imagination, sure, this card could represent somebody that's daydreaming or thinking a little too much. So you might have an active mind in this time, but this is also very, very creative. So whether you're going through good times or rough, this creativity could really, really serve you well. So we're just going to put that to the side for now. Let's get into tarot. And I always say this first card here, it doesn't make or break the reading. It's just a little footnote. So let's get you three tarot cards in the upright. Then we'll get into that intuitive juiciness. Shuffle it up one time here for my Saggies, please. And yeah, while we get this deck shuffled up and ready to go, let's talk about last week's reading. It was titled A Big Return. Now just know that this energy could still bleed over for a couple weeks. And what I was picking up heavily in your reading last week was something swinging back around. So whether that be a person or a situation, there was a familiarity with it. And I've been picking that up in other fire signs too, but things are prone to swing back around in this time, whether people or situations. So just keep that in mind. But we're going to see what shows up this week. As you know, energy is very fluid. It's never set in stone. So only take this how it hits for you, because we could be seeing your vibe or someone that you're linked to. Let's get it going though. Three cards for my Saggies, please. What is happening in early August for my friends? There we go, nice and quick. Okay, so we do have the Queen of Swords. Very stern, no nonsense type of energy. Now, I do know lots and lots of beautiful Saggies in my personal life. Very jovial, lighthearted type of people. But when I see this Queen of Swords, she is like about business. So we'll see how this shakes out. Let's get a couple more. Let's get a couple more. Six of Swords. So yeah, linking to that mind, we have double sword energy, which I also find intriguing. Let's get one more card out here, then we'll really piece it all together. What we got for Saggy early August? What do we got? There we go. Thank you. Ace of Wands. So we do have this fire-air combination showing up for you, which is not an energy that's super concerning, especially for a beautiful fire sign like yourself. But this could be a little bit unpredictable, that's for sure. So let's go through. I'll give you some of the classical meanings and archetypes, then we'll get into that juicy intuitive stuff. So at first glance, elementally, I do say that this is an element mix that can work well with Sagittarius because we have this double down of air energy. Air is the realm of communication and thought. We have fire, which is more about your internal combustion. It's very explosive, so it's great for taking action and making moves, but at the same time, there's an unpredictability, especially when you mix the elements together. There's like a volatility or an explosive aspect to the energy as a whole. So let's go through piece by piece and really start to build this out, because there's a lot of sub messages here and there could be some really nice stuff coming in. But position number one, we have the Queen of Swords. I already spoke about her a little bit. Let's talk about her more in depth. Now, this could be an air sign that you're linked to, and it doesn't have to be gender specific. So Gemini, Libra, Aquarius, any of those. But if that's not the case, this could be an energy that you are going to embody in the coming days and weeks. And when it comes to the Queen of Swords, as I mentioned earlier, she is no nonsense, no games, no BS. She is a straight talker, tell it like it is. If the truth hurts, it doesn't matter type of energy. So maybe that's an energy you carry. Listen, as a fire sign myself, I know we can be blunt sometimes. I know we don't realize how deep our words can cut. So I feel like for a lot of Saggies in this time, you're going to be much more direct than you normally are, which might be a bit of a scary thought, right? When we have the Queen of Swords. But a beautiful thing about this card also is that it's plan-based. It's analytical. It's strategic. So whether these are plans you're making, plans somebody else is making, I could see how this lays out that there could be a plan in play. Now, when it gets to the rough aspects of this Queen of Swords, she could be mean, right? She could be downright mean and hurting people's feelings. So hopefully no one's hurting your feels, but just something to keep watch of. And she does represent seriousness in one form or another. So whether it is a situation itself, a communication, we'll see. Moving to the center, we have the Six of Swords, a card of forward movement, progress, action. We really like this. And I always say that the Six of Swords is coming out of choppy waters into calm, coming out of a rough time into a positive. So this is a big card of solving problems, solving issues, or things improving. This is really nice. It's a card of travel and distance as well. So for some of you, whether it is taking a trip or shaking up your regular routine, this could be a big energy linked in with this. Now, I always say every card has that positive and challenge, right? So when it comes to the challenge of the Six of Swords, it could be on the move a little too much. This could be flighty. It could be a very skittish type of energy where it's like, boom, here, there, everywhere. It's like always moving around. And sometimes it could represent someone that either abandons things before they're finished or has unfinished business of some sort. That's in its roughest form, but we're not going to go that route just yet. We'll see. Now, on to the back end here is where we have our little spark plug. While we get that Six of Swords back by the Queen, we have the Ace of Wands. Love all aces. I say it every time they show up. They all represent offers and opportunities. They're big cards of communication and talking, which I find extra intriguing because we have this Queen of Swords planning, but also straight talking. We have the Six of Swords, which is of the swords talking. There is a big layer of communication showing up here. But yeah, this spark plug, the fire air, makes it explosive. Now, for some of you, it could be something coming in real quick or something that you don't see coming in. It just pops in, boom, like that. Now, the positives of this, it's filled with passion, desire, burn. Let's get this done. Let's get this moving. It could speak about your energy levels as a whole. But when it comes to the challenge, as I already mentioned, it could be hot-headed. It could be someone that's a little angry. It could represent things that are unpredictable. So we're going to have to see what shows up underneath when we clarify. I'm hoping that we get a little bit more of a stabilizing force. But I feel like right now the reading is kind of up in the air. So I want to dive deeper on all of it. Let's jump in and clarify. Get a good shuffle here. What do we have for my Saggy friends? Guides and spirit team, what's going on? And yes, this is where I go intuitive with the message, which means I just tell you how it feels to me. So feel free to do further research or rely on your base knowledge of tarot, because as you know, every single reading is about the reader's interpretation, and I'm just giving you mine. Let's go in on that Queen of Swords. And yes, if you're a reader yourself, please feel free to play along. That's why the box is here. If you're feeling any messages you want to give to Saggy, you drop it in the comments. I don't mind at all. Okay, Queen of Swords time. Talk to me. What do we have for Hermit? Ooh. Okay. So for a portion of you, I know I was speaking about there's a lot of communication and talking. When I see the Hermit and the Queen of Swords, like this is someone either minding their own business or keeping to themselves in one way or another, especially if it's in regards to talking. So for a portion of you, there may have been or is somebody that you're purposely not speaking with for the time being. If that's not the case to me, it could also represent someone that's kind of keeping their plans in the shadows at the moment, where it's like, okay, well, this is how it's going to go. First, this needs to happen, then this happens, then that happens, and then we can proceed. So for a portion of you, just know there might be someone that's laying out a plan of some sort in regards to whatever situations you're going through. There's a lot of strategy, but it's not known at the moment. But I can also see with this Queen of Swords and the Hermit, it's either someone keeping their mouth shut for one reason or another, like, I'm gonna keep this to myself, or it's like laying low, minding their own business. Okay, so with that's you or somebody else. Now the Hermit is Virgo energy, so you might be connected to a Virgo. If that's not the case, it's a card of wisdom, it's very spiritual, it sees things clearly, but it's keeping to itself. So those are the two main messages I'm picking up here on the front end. Obviously it doesn't have to be anything nefarious or too rough. We'll see how the reading plays as we move forward, but to me it's someone purposely keeping quiet, or it's someone that has a plan, or they are planning, but they're just keeping it to themselves for whatever reason. And I don't want to use terms like secret plan, but I mean it literally feels like that, where it's like, I'm waiting for this to happen, then this will happen, then I can make a move. Let's keep moving over to the Six of Swords. Let's get into the action now. So why is the Six of Swords here? Why is that six in the mix? I mean, I asked for some energy to stabilize, and the Hermit is earthy, so that makes sense. What is the Six of Swords thinking? Ten of Cups. Okay. And someone really feels like something could work, or it could work out in one way or another. This is very positive energy. It's someone that's extremely optimistic, and it's like, no, I think this could actually work. So in regards to, like, planning and strategy, I feel like there's good purpose behind it, or someone has good intentions behind their plans and strategy. The Ten of Cups is a card of straight up winning, of victories. It's your cup runneth over, and in the positive, this is just really beautiful. I think for a lot of Sagittarians, whether you're going through rough things or in between things or no things at all, there is something that really could come in and go way better than you possibly think. So I am seeing, once again, a big win victory type of energy here. Now, when we mix it in with all this explosive energy on top, could it be something that happens suddenly or explosively? Absolutely. That's what I'm seeing here. It could be an explosive win or victory that just happens really quick. But again, I feel like something could go way better than you think it will. I don't feel like we need to overcomplicate this too much. I will say for some Saggies, there's an energy here around relocation as well. Obviously, not every Sagittarius, but some of you with the Six of Swords, Ten of Cups, that's a card of family and home. There's an energy of relocation playing into something. So let's keep moving over. Let's see what that Ace of Wands spark plug has to say. Then we'll do a quick little recap before we get into the shadow. Okay, because I'm seeing good intentions. That's the positive thing for sure. This is a very optimistic energy in the center. And I said it in the beginning, Sagittarius energy to me is happy. It's jovial. It's mostly optimistic from what I understand. So let's go in on that Ace of Wands. Why is it here? Quick. To want another card of planning. Another card of planning showing up here right to bookend the back end. We have the Two of Wands. Okay, so that explosive energy is holding through, and I feel like it is victorious. And I feel like, again, someone's plans coming to fruition, or how they want it to go. So if you're just coasting through and you're dealing with certain things and you're just being intuitive about it and just going with the flow, that might not be the optimal way to handle a situation. For some of you, I feel like it needs to be a little more structured. And I was seeing this in the Aries reading too, like whatever it is you're going through, whether good, bad, or in between, bringing some structure to it. And I know, listen, as fire sign, I already mentioned it. I know sometimes a little too much structure can make us feel like we're cornered. I feel like in whatever situations you're going through, planning for the different eventualities, planning for the unexpected. Now, you can't plan for everything. That's just how this reality is set up. But this Two of Wands is really, really good. And this also being a card of strategy, I feel like someone's plans coming to fruition or going the way they think. So just know in this time, if you like set out some sort of plan into motion, I feel like if you plan it properly, I don't see why it can't happen if you're realistic about it. Okay, if that's not the case, this is someone that could be waiting from afar or waiting for something to happen, which in that case, I would say like this person needs to get get to action or get to moving in one way or another, because there can't be two energy just waiting on something else to happen. Okay, that's another vibe I'm picking up here, where it's like this person's waiting, waiting, waiting. This person's doing the same. It's like, all right, these energies need to meet in the middle. Let's go through and do a quick recap, because I'm getting all sorts of different flavors of stuff, but I like what I'm picking up for the most part. But if you kindly look in the box here, my Sagittarius friends, position number one is where we first start getting this analytical plan-based type of energy with the Queen of Swords and the Hermit. Now, for a portion of you, this could be a person you're like not really speaking with right now. It could also represent just laying low, doing your own thing. But the big vibe I was picking up is someone that just has a plan and they're keeping it to themselves, where it's like they're setting road marks or goals, like, okay, well, when this happens, then I could do that. And when this happens, then I could do this. It's like a very carefully laid plan, and someone is very serious about sticking to it. Moving to the center, we have the Six of Swords with the Ten of Cups. There's great intentions behind this. That's how it feels to me. So whether you're having difficulties with someone or not, I feel like the intentions aren't meant to be harmful. And I get this explosive wind type of energy too, where it's like, okay, this could pick up steam real quick, quicker than you think. And this could happen very quickly with all the fire and air on the top. Onto the back end, we have the Ace of Wands with the Two of Wands, more planning. Now, at the end, I did get that little vibe where it's like, all right, well, this person's not doing action. They're just planning. This one's doing the same. I feel like two energies might need to meet in the middle in one way or another. But the big thing I was picking up is someone's plan actually working, actually coming to fruition. So just know if you're going through certain things right now, you need to structure it for the best possible outcome. So yeah, please take a screenshot of that, Saggy. Different reading than what I usually get for you, that's for sure. It just feels like a lot more regimented. But let's see what's in the shadows for you. Shuffle it up one time and see what we have for Saggy, please. And yes, I always like to pull one shadow card at the very end just to see whether it's something within you or something you don't quite see. Shadow cards don't always have to be a challenge. They could be a good thing. So let's get you one. And if you've made it to this point in the reading, please feel free to check out channel memberships. I'll put a link for it in the comments below. It's a beautiful way to support the channel, and I have much love for all my channel members. Okay, let's get this going. What do we have for Saggy, please? In the shadows. Thank you. Queen of Pentacles, huh? Another individual starting to show up here. Now, I do like Queen of Pentacles energy, aside from the energy that sometimes it could be a little bit stubborn, but let's talk about it. The Queen of Pentacles, if you're not connected to an earth sign, remember, it's not gender specific. So Capricorn, Virgo, Taurus, we already have Virgo showing up within this reading. The Queen of Pentacles is like the Empress Light when I see it. So she is a big card of blessings and abundance and fertility. She represents motherhood and mother figure. So for a portion of you with this card in the shadow, we are seeing that maternal connection for one reason or another. But if that's not the case, if we're not speaking about that type of stuff, I just feel things blossoming and blooming. So with the energy about the planning and things coming to fruition, this could be a very positive shadow card that we're picking up. Now, if we're not talking about a person and we're not talking about the beautiful blessings that the universe could have in store, I see the Queen of Pentacles and she is very steadfast. Sometimes this is an energy that's a little bit stubborn. So I feel like I need to tell some Saggies in this time, if you were dealing with a person that is hard-headed or stubborn in this time, don't expect that to change. That's just how it's coming through. So, Saggy, that's what I have for you this week, my beautiful friends. Don't click away just yet, though. I'm going to give you the details of the August subscriber surprise. If you would like to book a personal reading with me, you can check out my digital calendar at my website, mastermetaphysics.com. And for the July subscriber surprise, the winners will be announced after this week's fire and air readings. But for the August subscriber surprise, I'm giving away two copies of the beautiful Gilded Tarot Royale, one of my favorite decks ever. So if you'd like to get your name in for this, it's two simple things. As always, my friends, first, you must be subscribed. And second, let me know down in the comments, if you could time travel, would you rather go into the past to meet your ancestors, or would you rather go into the future to meet your descendants? You'll be entered to win, and at the end of the month, the winners will be announced in my community tab. As always, my friends, much love, and I'll see you soon.